Hey, Grant here from the Surface Saver. So this video covers shower tray crack repairs. There's two crack repairs and a chip repair that we cover in this video. Shows you how to get your shower tray looking great again without replacing it. Obviously we don't do the small spot repair kits because they're useless, so resurfacing the whole tray is the way to go with the proper filler. We'll show you that. All the kit is available. Just click the link in the description box, or if you're already on our website, click through to our order page and place your order. So it's a great little video, shows you how to get a great looking shower tray without replacing it, and happy resurfacing. Okay, so as with all resurfacing, start off by giving the tray a really good clean, and give it a good thorough rinse, and dry everything off as well. Make it all nice and clean and bone dry before you start. So this is the tray that we're doing today. You can see the small crack there, the small chip, and there's a nasty crack right around the plug hole. So first of all, with the crack, you want to make sure you drill it a few times, especially at either end to stop the crack getting worse, and then a couple of times in the middle. And then once you've done that, scrape away any of the burrs of plastic with a Stanley blade that's in the kit. Mask around all of the damaged areas with the masking tape that's in the kit. This saves everything from getting too messy. Now mask off and cut around the drain cover with the masking tape and scalpel in the kit, because we don't want this to get damaged in the next stage. Remove the excess tape, and with the wet and dry paper that's in the kit, sand down any sharp edges that are on the crack. With the sharp edges now rounded off, take the tape from the kit and tape all the way around the damaged crack so you can really work the filler in without causing too much mess. Squeeze out the required amount of filler onto the mixing card and add the hardener in a ratio of about a golf ball size to a pea size for filler to hardener. Mix thoroughly until all the filler is all one color, and then smear into the damaged areas, pressing quite hard to begin with, and then lighter and lighter as the layers build up. Now for the crack around the plug. Work the filler into the crack all the way around, and take the stick provided and clean off around the plug hole itself. Working quickly with your finger, smooth out the filler to form what looks like the original curve of the drain. Once again, use the stick provided to clean to get a nice sharp edge around the drain and remove the tape. Once you've removed all the masking tape except what's covering the drain, take the wet and dry paper from the kit and wet it, and smooth off all the edges of the filler. Sand the filler around the plug smooth, and then remove the tape from the plug and give everything a really good dry with the paper towel. Dry really thoroughly around the plug into the cracks to make sure all the moisture's out. Once again, mask off the drain cover with a masking tape, cut around and remove the excess. Now, once you've finished masking off the drain, mask off the edge of the shower tray. Now these could be tiles, it could be the shower screen, but whatever you don't want the material to come into contact with, mask off, ready for resurfacing. Now the prep work's done, it's time to mix up the material. Pour the hardener into the main tub and gently warm the tub while you're mixing thoroughly for at least 10 minutes, making sure to mix in all of the sides of the tub. Once fully mixed after 10 minutes, it should be the consistency of double cream. Now it's time to start resurfacing. So take the mixing stick out of the tub and discard. And with a full cup, start in each corner and pour a thick layer and allow the material to run into the corners and down. Pour another full cup, and where you've just started, move from that corner to another corner and all the way around. The aim of the game here is just to get the material on nice and thick and make sure there's no bald spots. The material will find its own level and cover everything to a beautiful finish. Pour the rest of the material into the cup and apply into the base and any of the sides that you can see that are still uncovered. You don't have to worry at all with this material about being super precise. It's such an easy material to work with. As long as you get it on nice and thick, we'll take the roller from the kit and use it just to move the material around, just to cover any of the bald spots, and then let the material do its thing and self-level. You can see here now, all you need to do is just use the roller to push the material around, making sure you've covered any of the bald spots that are on the walls, then working the material from the edges to the center. And then finally, once you've moved all the material from the edges to the center, do a few crisscrosses back and forth just to help the material self-level. At this stage, it's always helpful to try and get the excess material out of the plug, and then, as before, crisscross, working from the edges to the center. You may notice as you're resurfacing that there's little tiny bubbles forming, but don't worry, just blast them with a hot air gun and they'll pop within a couple of seconds. Now that's all the resurfacing done. All we need to do now is remove the excess material from the drain, remove the masking tape, and do any sealing work that's required if the shower is already fitted. Use paper towel to start the process of mopping up the excess from the drain, and use the stick provided with the kit to scoop out the excess material from around the drain cover. Once you've used paper towel to mop up the majority of the excess, you might find it easier then to use a gloved finger just to take up the excess and to make sure all of the filler is covered with the material. You might have spotted that something's fallen in, but don't worry, just take the cocktail stick provided and pick it out. As soon as you finish resurfacing, you want to start taking the excess material out of the plug and then remove the masking tape from around the edge. About 20 minutes after resurfacing, we noticed it was starting to pool on the edge that we started off with. But don't worry, just start from the edge and work that excess material into the center, and it'll level out itself in no time. Now, after about half an hour after resurfacing, take this opportunity to clear around the plug again and use the stick provided to scoop up the excess. Now, depending on the height of your waist cap, you may have to remove the material every half an hour for 2 to 3 hours until the material stops running over the waist cap. And again, if you spot any air bubbles, hit it for a couple of seconds with the heat gun. Now, when you're sure the material has stopped flowing over the drain, like it hasn't had to be cleared for about an hour or so at least, it should be safe then to remove the masking tape from the waist cap. Now, once you remove the masking tape from the waist cap, you may notice that there's some extra residue of material that's now on the waist cap. But don't worry, this can be removed. Just wipe it carefully with paper towel until it's now clean again. So this is the finished result. This tray is good as new. No sign of that damage, no sign of the cracks, no sign of the chip, or that nasty waste pipe crack. You can use the techniques that we've shown you in this video and apply them to fix almost any type of shower tray damage and get it looking great again. Click the link in the description box to order the kit, or if you're on our website, just click through to the order form.